Hello, we're back. I'm going to continue on in these lectures on the membrane. We ended on this one in the last mini lecture on equilibrium about how the total volume of solute per volume of fluid must be the same in all fluid compartments. So what that really means is that if you counted all the molecules of solute that were outside of the cell and all the molecules inside the cell, they have to be equal. The thing is, they don't have to be the same ones. So you don't have to have equal numbers of sodium out to those in, equal numbers of potassium out to those in. No, it's just the total number out needs to be the same as that in order for you to have osmotic equilibrium. To review the fluid compartments again, it's the intracellular, the interstitial, and the plasma. Said it backwards this time. There is a video on this that's also available for you. You should watch it. It's named Intracellular and Extracellular Compartments. This is a much better picture than the one I showed you last time. If you have a cell, you could have that water inside the cell, or it could be outside the cell. Outside the cell would mean it would be in this bluish purple region or inside the actual plasma. Remember, it's the equilibrium between all of those is crucial. More diagrams on that showing you the intracellular, about two-thirds of the total body water volume, and then the extracellular made up of both interstitial, that's the term meaning surrounding the cell, or within the blood plasma. And that's about a third of the total body water volume is going to be either in the blood or surrounding those cells. These diagrams are all in your text. This figure shows the volumes approximate for about a 70 kilogram male. So in the form of a bar graph, it's easier to visualize how you have 28 liters approximately of this fluid inside the cell, approximately 14 on the outside of the cell. And of that, most of it is interstitial. It's a nice way to look at it. I'm going to skip the slide about if you had 28 liters in one and 14 in the other. And you had the percentages there of 25% and 75, you should be able to calculate what the volume of the plasma and the volume of the interstitial fluid was. This slide is interesting. It's telling us that the body compartments are in a state of chemical disequilibrium when it comes to thinking about the individual solutes. Correct? So now if we broke it down into where's the sodium, where's the potassium, where's the chlorine, this is a nice graph to show that. So within the inside of the cell, let's look here first. Remember that they're in equilibrium as a whole, but not when it comes to the individual solutes. So when it comes to the individual solutes in the intracellular fluid, what do we have a ton of? Potassium. What else? Proteins, large proteins that cannot cross the membrane. They're stuck inside that cell. And what do we have much less of? Much less sodium, much less bicarbonate and chlorine. All right, so let's compare that. That's within the cell. Now let's see that fluid that's floating outside of the cell, the interstitial fluid. What is it? Very high in sodium. So just as intracellular fluid is high in potassium, interstitial fluid outside the cell is high in sodium. It's also high in chlorine and relatively low in bicarbonate and potassium. What does the plasma look like? A little different. It has a lot of sodium. It has quite a bit of chlorine and also those proteins, those clotting proteins, there's a lot of those clotting proteins in blood. So that's going to be high too. So this big picture you should understand. You should know this. You should know that when I'm talking about within the cell, I'm talking about a lot of potassium. When it's outside the cell, it's going to be a lot of sodium. Now, to keep it this way is complicated. To keep it this way, it's going to take energy. You're going to have to be pumping the wrong one out if there's too many, or bringing the correct one in if there's too few. So it's hard work on the cell. Quote, the concentration differences of chemical disequilibrium are the hallmark of a living organism. Remember, the disequilibrium means of the individual solutes. I'm leaving this for you to look at a little bit longer. I'm going to say it again. The concentration differences of chemical disequilibrium are the hallmark of a living organism. Well, what if it's not working? What if that equilibrium is lost? Loss of equilibrium moves water, right? It could move water between the compartments. And what if I move it out from the inside of the cell to the outside of the cell? What am I going to have? Edema. So I drew a big fat leg on this poor little guy. And that is accumulation of fluids. You know that when you're swollen, you have a limb that's swollen. It's because there is fluid out of its correct compartment. Also, think about when a cell actually dies. Let's say there's cell death. Then that disequilibrium is not going to be maintained. You're not going to have more sodium outside the cell and more potassium inside. What's going to happen is that they're going to equilibrate, right? And sodium is going to flow wherever it needs to flow, and potassium is going to flow wherever it needs to flow, and it's going to return to randomness, or the loss of that disequilibrium. And that is death, cell death. And if that happens in too many cells, my poor little stick person here dies. So that's where we're going to stop this mini lecture. Be ready for the next one. Thank you guys for listening.